Hey guys, and welcome back to another installment with GetWinesDirect. Hopefully you got something out of our last video, which was a Q&A. So just because we're not asking you to bring up any questions with us in the polls, doesn't mean you can't keep the questions rolling on through, whether it's in our live chat or any of our socials, which you'll find in the description down below. So today we've got something a little bit different. So it's not a Q&A. We're going to be checking out two wines from the same producer, the Lambert Estate. Now, we've had these guys in a few times recently, and I'm actually personally a big fan of their red blend, which is called the Black Sheep. I've had their 2012 all the way through to 2015. And today, it's a little bit exciting. I'm getting to try the 2017. So hopefully, it lives up to expectations for me, and then I can give you some good feedback about that too. And then the second one, which we have on our right, is the Mustang Sally, a brilliant name for hopefully what is to be a big, bold Barossa Shiraz. Now, I remember the first time we got this in, and a lot of people knew about the Lambert Estate being in the Barossa Valley, and I think we sold this out. I think people went crazy. It wasn't even like a Black Friday or a Cyber Monday or anything like that. It was just a normal day. I think it was gone within about 2 hours. So pretty crazy, and I'm looking forward to trying one of their newest released vintages. So without further ado, let's jump in. So let's get started. We've got the Black Sheep in front of me, in case you skipped forward to the best part, which is trying wine. Now this is the 2017. Now last time I remember trying the 2015 was actually last week, luckily enough. My partner and I really enjoy it. And the red blend that the Black Sheep offers is a beautiful mix of some dark currants and lovely cherry, and a lot of red cherries on top of that to give it that lovely balanced texture. So you are going to find this isn't an extremely heavy wine, but that means it's very easy to drink. So if we just give it a quick sniff. Yeah, just coming straight off the nose there, you really are getting that red cherry coming through. It does have a little bit of plum on the backbone there too, so just to give it a little bit more body. I think if I can recall, actually, let me just check for you. Yeah, so this is the 14.5% alcohol. So obviously they are still going to be heavier in terms of alcohol, but it's actually quite deceiving, because this wine, I know throughout their previous vintages, it's very, very smooth. So do be careful if you do start to really enjoy this. It is actually a little bit on the heavier side for alcohol, especially in terms of Australian wines. We know we like them big. So you got to give it three sips to really, really appreciate the wine. And last but not least, yeah. Once again, they've knocked it out of the ballpark. I think the bottle, I think we are very lucky. I think it normally sells around that $30 mark. We're very lucky to supply it at a far lower price, so that's great for us. But you really will see the quality there. I can also taste, which is quite interesting, a little bit of what people might class as eucalyptus, because it does have a slight deeper, but almost like a fresher, mintier vibe towards the back end, which I would normally actually class as being something from more of the Coonawarra region. So it's very interesting to find that in a Barossa. But you know, all that being said, it's a superb little wine. If I was to class this, I would class this as a great, great, you know, evening meal wine. So I think it is a little bit up a par from a normal quaffa, which you just grab, you know, for an afternoon delight. But that being said, a brilliant wine. I really enjoyed that one, but I can't wait to see what's next. So next wine, Mustang Sally from the Lambert Estate. It's their 2018 vintage. So a lot of people may think that this might be a bit too young for a lot of Shiraz, but don't forget, a lot of producers are starting to make their wines so that you can drink them when they're young. So a lot of them will also not have as much oak. They'll also not increase the tannin or the tannic level within the wine because it doesn't need to sit for a longer period of time to be enjoyed. So let's get into it. So I'm just gonna give it a quick smell now. So normally when I think Barossa, and I think a lot of other people, we're gonna think pepper. Pepper is generally a big thing for the Barossa region. But I know a lot of them are actually moving away from this as they are starting to create younger wines. They're looking at more of those subtle but lovely flavors like cinnamon, toast, nutmeg. So we'll just give it a sniff. Yeah, I'm definitely getting a lot of that plum, which is quite consistent with a heavier Shiraz. It definitely is heavier than that red blend. But it's, funnily enough, this is actually the same alcoholic volume. So this is also 14.5%. So like I said before, don't let that red blend really, you know, deceive you, because it is just as heavy in terms of alcoholic level. So I can smell that cinnamon and that toast. It is quite subtle on that backbone there. But I mean, a lot of the time with these younger wines, you are gonna get more of those fruit-driven flavors at the start. So we're gonna give it three sips to make sure it's all good. That's number one. Now, I am really gathering from that, you do have that underlying savory note. A little bit of cinnamon. I wouldn't say it's extremely powerful there, but you are getting a plum. It's not extremely deep. It's not possibly quite as heavy as I would normally classify a Barossa Shiraz, but it does have that fruitiness that I would actually tend to think of as something from the Margaret River, but not quite at that level. So it's actually quite a nice balance. I would even say it reminds me a little bit more of that McLaren Vale, because it has that spice notes, but it's actually quite lovely. Let's give it another go. There we go. As I start to delve into this wine, it's starting to tell me more about its story. And I can start to taste, more of those savory notes coming through as I start to swirl that around. It's a great way. You want to make sure if you can get those three sips beforehand, because it really pulls the flavors. Now, last but not least, I am going to sip this like a wine snob for a second. So don't judge me. There we go. Yep, it needed a bit of snobbery in there, because as soon as I did that, I pulled out the alcohol. So I pulled out those vapors, and all I could taste was straight fruit. But by gosh, that cinnamon does really kick in once you start to remove that. So the longer you let this sit, the better. I would say it's not an extremely heavy Shiraz, so maybe half hour to 40 minutes. You know, if you chuck it in a blender, you're probably going to be good within about 15 seconds. But yeah, you can really taste it start to come through. So it's actually a lovely Shiraz, especially for a younger one. And once again, like I said before, generally these are a bit more expensive. We were very lucky enough to be able to get them at a great price for you guys. So I definitely recommend it. A brilliant little wine to crack open, maybe for a barbecue. It's going to go really well with some stronger meats. You know, some strong cuts, maybe like a ribeye. Or, you know, an eye fillet or something like that. But yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed this today. If you've got any questions, guys, don't forget, you can message us, whether it's in our live chat, our online service, giving us a call, or checking out one of the socials. We're always happy to answer your questions. But until next time, keep drinking.